Hi everyone, it's John. Hope you're doing well. Since I've been here on YouTube, I wanted to go over some things about myself. I first mentioned the fact that I was autistic, and I didn't find out until I was 16. I was a contestant on The Price is Right, and then I mentioned or showed you some kids' television shows that influenced me, as well as game shows, sitcoms, and cartoons. Now I'm going to show you what live-action television shows have done to me, and it is, like I said in my last video towards the end, that it's a big piece of the puzzle as to why I'm doing this kind of thing on YouTube and why I am here on YouTube. I'm going to start by showing you Touched by an Angel. Touched by an Angel was about a group of angels who were sent here on Earth from God, Heavenly Father, to show us that we are all His children and each and every one of us has a life to live for and we are all special and unique. Like I was saying all along in previous videos, and each and every one of us is gifted and has a life to live for, and that we should care for one another and should be accepting one another as we are. I'm going to show you the theme song from Touched by an Angel from 2002, which was their last season, and it was sang by Della Reese, who played Tess on the series. Take a look.
When you walk down the road, heavy burden, heavy load, I will rise and I will the sun don't even shine. Walk with you. Every time I tell you I'll walk with you. Believe me, I'll walk with you.
Now I'm going to show you the last episode from 2003. In it, an actor who played Zach, who was actually representing Jesus Christ in human form, he was accused of murdering people, and we all know he didn't do it. And everyone else later found out that he didn't either. And Monica or Roma Downey wanted to tell him that he was innocent, and here is that.
Forgive me. I didn't know who you were.
I hardly ever do, Monica.
Why didn't I recognize you?
Because you would have done anything for me. But look what you did for a stranger. And greater love hath no person nor angel than to give her life for another. Well done, good and faithful servant.
And that really touched me and made me feel good about my own self, that there is someone always watching out for you. And moving on to Power Rangers. Power Rangers started here in America in 1993. It was originally from Japan as a Japanese program, and there were two films done. One was done in 1995 as Mighty Morphin Power Rangers the movie, and in 1997 as Turbo, a Power Rangers movie. I'm going to show you an episode from 1997 with Rocky, who was played by Steve Cardenas, giving up his powers to Justin, who was played by Blake Foster. Take a look.
I still can't believe you don't want your powers back, Rocky. It's so cool being a ranger.
Yeah, but I got a lot of stuff to do with my karate school, and I don't know. I think the power's in good hands.
Right, Rock. But remember, you'll always be a Power Ranger in spirit.
That's nice. This is Adam.
And Steve Cardenas wanted to do what he always has done before Power Rangers and during Power Rangers, and that was teach martial arts. And he still continues to today. My point is, it doesn't matter what your job is. It's who you are and how you go about doing it that makes a difference. And Steve teaches something to his students about how to defend yourself against bullies. And I was bullied during elementary school and middle school. But that was because no one back then knew about me. And, oh my gosh, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to show you another someone, Richard Dean Anderson from MacGyver from 1986. Take a look.
MacGyver, what are you doing?
Little experiment.
What sort of experiment?
Francois, the first men to fly over Paris were French. The Montgolfier brothers?
Of course. The first hot air balloons. Mon Dieu, merveilleux.
MacGyver taught us another thing, and that is the fact that we have a right to live. And it's not right to take a gun and shoot someone. And if you had a family problem, MacGyver would try to fix it. Because when MacGyver was growing up, my parents were divorced. And it was a very difficult time, but what I'm getting at is that you are you, and I am me. And MacGyver, at the end, found out that he had a son, and they decided to go on and start their lives all over again, because MacGyver didn't know he had a son. So, take a look.
You know, I can't even imagine what it's going to be like without you around here.
Well, it was bound to happen. Things change.
Not always. Good things don't. Don't you ever change, MacGyver.
Don't you either, Pete.
The reason is I showed you that was because the show ended in 1992. And Richard Dean Anderson, who played MacGyver, gets a whole bunch of interesting things asking, can you fix my alarm clock or something? And what I'm here to show is that people cannot just do that as an actor. They were given screenplays, scripts, and were directed to do so. And I think we, this day and age, are kind of missing that element to a small extent. What I'm going to show you right now is something that really bothered me. A couple years ago in 2011, someone kind of took his identity. Take a look.
Richard Dean Anderson here. It's way too early in the morning to be doing this. In fact, I kind of resent having to do it at all, but there are some people, a couple of couples that are representing themselves on Facebook as me. They've got a couple, there are a couple of sites up, actually there are many, many sites up apparently, that are invoking my name as being the responder. It's not happening. I don't have a Facebook account, let alone am I holding court on a site. So.
And I feel the same way that Richard does. And I think that, again, we should be reminded that we're all still human. It doesn't matter what we look like. It doesn't matter what our job is. What does matter is what we do with our lives. That's important. And everyone in this world has a life to live for. Everyone should be kind to one another, should be treating everyone in the same kind of respect. next time when we're together, I'll show you someone who has done that and continues to do that in a television platform. Until we meet again, John Toomey saying peace and bye.